The Surgeon General has said that misinformation about COVID amounts to a public health crisis.
Yes.
I'm wondering, regardless of ownership, would the White House be interested in working with Twitter like it has in the past to continue to combat this kind of misinformation? Or are we in a different part of the pandemic where that kind of partnership is no longer necessary?
Well, I think we engage regularly with all social media platforms about steps that can be taken. That has continued, and I'm sure it will continue. But there are also reforms that we think Congress could take, and we would support taking, including reforming Section 230, enacting antitrust reforms, requiring more transparency, and the president is encouraged by the bipartisan support for or engagement in those efforts.
Look, who knows? I think that's an example of a broader question for Twitter, which is, if you get invited to something where there are no rules, where there is total freedom for everybody, do you actually want to go to that party? Or are you going to decide to stay home? And that's a question for Twitter users. Some Twitter users might love the idea that there's going to be absolutely no moderation and no rules at all. Others might not want to be anywhere near that. Am I crazy, Matt?
No, you're right. And what happens to the advertising? I mean, if there's no moderation or little moderation, do the advertisers stay away? What does that do to the business prospects for Twitter itself?
I think that's very much